Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. I'm still a little bit under the weather, so I apologize for my lack of uploads over the past few days. In this video tonight, I'd like to talk a little bit more about what we just saw during the Game Awards with Modern Warfare 2 and Season 1 Reloaded. It's officially dropping on December 14th. We ended up getting some small shots of the brand new shipment experience, and we also got a pretty extended look at what raids are kind of going to be like, and it really makes me excited for what's going to be happening in the future, and I just wanted to discuss that here in this video today. So first things first, shipment is shipment. It looks dark and gritty, and I'm excited to know that it's happening on an actual shipping boat. It's going to be pretty cool to see how that all goes down. Obviously, it's hard to tell from these small little snippets that we got if the boat's actually shaking or moving back and forth, but I'd like to imagine that there's going to be some, you know, waves crashing against the side and maybe some changes in gameplay from time to time. As for raids, this one has me really, really excited because unlike the Spec Ops missions, raids are going to be taking us to brand new locations outside of Al-Mazra. Episode 1 is titled Atomgrad, and this gets me really, really excited because it makes me think back to Cold War and the USSR and all the different Atomgrads that they created secretly. Atomgrads are meant for nuclear weapon research and development and different types of production, and I think that it's really got a lot of secrets behind it, and it gets me excited to think about where we could be going next with this story. And when you think about the ending of MW2 and what happened, I won't spoil anything, it just makes sense to go this way in terms of intel gathering and what the team should be doing. Now, a couple of things that I want to point out directly from the gameplay that we ended up getting. Number one, the Red Team 141 outfits are not present. We have Gaz, Farah, and of course Price all in their normal outfits. I really wonder how this is going to be done in-game because, as of right now, Captain Price and Farah do not have a normal outfit, do not have a normal original character skin. I would hope that they just get added for free for everybody, but something tells me it's going to go the line of Gaz where people have to pay to get the original skin, which would just be fucking stupid. Now, secondly, I think that it's important to mention that with this raid, it's going to be very important to work as a team. I'm a little bit bummed that it's not four players, but I really like how they're wrapping the story elements in this. You go down this absolutely forgotten underground passage, you start to lose comms with Laswell, and from there you dig deeper and deeper and deeper till you find the intel that your team is looking for, and it's all about sticking together and surviving to the very end. Now, what the entire outcome of a raid is, we have no freaking clue, but it looks like it's almost like a labyrinth that you would encounter in Destiny, essentially, where you have different checkpoints where you need to take down specific enemies in order to navigate to the next one. You could do it silently or going guns blazing. Obviously, that's always been a choice, but I think that this is really going to bring people to an entirely different dimension when we start interacting with the AI. At one point, you can see that there's bomb drones that are currently patrolling different pipeways, and there's lots of water combat that's happening, and what I really like here is the usage of unique equipment that's probably only going to be part of raids. So for example, at this section right here, you can see that our character is utilizing a handheld oxygen tank, being able to have more oxygen while making their way through a flooded waterway. Now, where this goes, we'll have to wait and see when the raid officially releases, but I think that that's pretty damn cool, and it makes me wonder just how big these areas are. But not only that, I'm really curious how many of these episodes, if not all of them, are going to have complete together cutscenes, because it seems like, based off of what we've been seeing so far through this very small teaser, we are going to have a pretty extensive amount of cutscenes, and I think that that's probably going to be one of the ultimate rewards for the first team that goes through and completes the raid successfully, being able to upload that cutscene. Essentially, it's kind of like completing a zombie Easter egg, I would imagine. This is probably going to have a pretty challenging twist and turn, and if you're not able to complete it the first time, another team does, and they're going to see the cutscene first. But one thing I do want to point out, at the very end, when Gaz flips on the lights, kind of goes hand in hand with what I was saying earlier, you could see for a very brief second over here in the corner a pretty distinct red star. So I would imagine that they probably just uncovered some nukes that are probably ready to be launched. Maybe the research has been ongoing. Obviously, there's tons of enemies down here, so they're protecting something and they're preparing something. So this is really going to add an entirely new layer to what's going to be happening, not only in the campaign, but also in the multiplayer. I say multiplayer because I'd like to imagine that that's probably going to dictate where we end up going next in terms of multiplayer maps. But if we keep getting remakes, then maybe it'll just be remakes in those specific areas. I have no fucking clue. Alternatively, maybe at the end they didn't discover a nuke at all. Maybe it's something completely different, but with a name like Atomgrad, I wouldn't be really holding my breath on that one. One major concern that I had, and we spoke about this a few days ago, about Season 1 Reloaded and raids in general, I was really worried that raids would not have its own identity. Raids would feel too similar to Spec Ops, and it wouldn't be able to carry its own torch, and that makes me wonder how large these experiences are going to be, how many different paths you can take, and or if there are alternate ways to complete the mission rather than just going from point A to point B. I'm also wondering if there are different missions within the mission to complete, kind of like the DMZ, where you have different missions from each one of the groups that you can complete, and by the time you exfil, you can complete all of them or start some of them, or you guys get what I'm saying. It would be really cool if that's the case too, because then it would add some replay value. I think that's one of my main concerns. You know, the team at Infinity Ward plans on dumping a bunch of time into these episodes, and they plan on going all out with them, and multiplayer ends up getting two remake maps, then I would really, really hope that there's at least some sort of replayability here that people can enjoy time and time again and still come back and play. I'm also curious if they're going to be adding a ton of Easter eggs, and I'm not talking like on the level of zombies or anything, but like little Easter eggs that you could find, intel pieces that you could pick up, stuff that you would only be able to find in that raid, and if you pick it up, you'd be able to bring it back to multiplayer, DMZ, Warzone 2.0, and you could utilize it in your creative class. Here's a good example of that. Say there is a section of this raid where you need to stay underwater for a long period of time, which we know that there's probably going to be something like that because we saw the handheld air canisters. But what if there was a way to survive just a little bit longer and there's like a secret room with just a little pocket of air? And if you manage to get there with your very last health bar, like one more little gulp of water would take you down. There's like a really badass blueprint there, or maybe like a relic of the past, like an AK that you would only be able to find, and it was supposed to be lost to time, but if you bring it back out, you can have it forever. Like, that would be cool. I would totally be down for something like that, and I'd love to see them do something like that, but I don't know. I guess we'll have to wait and see. I'm really hoping that there's replay value here, but that's one of my big concerns. Anyway, that's pretty much everything I want to talk about here. As soon as we get more official information, which might be as soon as tomorrow, I'll make sure to keep y'all posted right here on the channel. If you guys enjoyed this commentary, do me a favor, drop a like on this video. Subscribe for more coming every day. And if you saw something cool in the teaser that maybe we all missed, let us know in the comments section below. Alrighty, folks, I will catch you on the next video. Peace.